That's what we are. That's how God wants us to see things. So it doesn't sound so far out to, you know, say, yes, you're entitled, you're righted, divinely so, constitutionally so, to share in the inherent wealth of this planet and your nation, okay, by extension, and your community by extension, and to give and take, right? That's what we share, you know, this whole idea of bartering. Yes, I give my services and look what I can take from, you know, being willing to give. And even if somebody's not willing to give, like Adam Smith pointed out in The Wealth of Nations, a civilized society can withstand quite a bit of idleness. Okay, so if people do want to be lazy, that's their problem. They're not relevant. They're not in the game. They don't get any attention. They're not doing nothing. So, you know, who can be grateful? People love to people to be grateful to them for doing so. They go, wow, thank you. You know, they pray, they bless them in their heart. You know, just even that, if they don't tell you thank you, but you know you're being blessed and they are grateful for what you had given them. That's what all people are after. That's the satisfaction they get. Like King Solomon said, the greatest satisfaction you could do under the sun is doing your work, doing your thing, exercising, utilizing your talents, expressing your talents. If you're an artist, you know, wild horses can't keep you away from doing your thing, man. You just give and give and give, and nothing can stop you from giving and doing. And that's something we all understand as humans. We really can. We could tap into our godly nature and understand this thing, how a society could work entirely without any form of money. Eventually, we could get there. But, you know, that's why it's going to be traumatic to a lot of people. I mean, if Jesus Christ does return tomorrow, if the Bible is true and it's all literal and not some metaphor, but even if it was a metaphor, then eventually this new age is going to come and there's going to be this huge sea change in the paradigm, the thinking of humanity, where we're going to be empowered and we're going to cast out the evildoers and we're going to be free and we're going to be happy and content and live in safety and security with our neighbors and peace and prosperity and freedom and all these good things that we all want. It's coming, even if it was a metaphor. But it would be traumatic if, you know, it happened the way it's written in the Bible, where a lot of people are caught with their pants down, and it comes suddenly upon them like a thief in the night, like Jesus described, because they didn't ready themselves. They just thought it was hogwash. Oh, well, it's a metaphor. Even a lot of Christians are going to be caught, they're going to be caught flat-footed because they just didn't take it literally. They just didn't realize that really we were living at the end of the age and the beginning of a new age, because the two are seamless. So it's going to be abrupt maybe for a lot of people. But if you're ready, if you ready your heart and mind for what God has in mind, what it's going to be like on this earth, then it won't be so traumatic for you. And that's where I'm at. I'm ready. I want it, man. So I hate my life in this world. I hate money. I wish it didn't exist. I wish it was never invented or tolerated. Okay, no other creature has any use for the stuff. Rather have a bite of its favorite food. Every single other creature. But yet every single one of us would rather have $1 million and a bite of our favorite food. We've all bought into it. So there's no lying to God. All the only way out of this thing is just being ready for not having it and to live free. It was never invented by God. When you catch a fish out of the ocean, God doesn't appear out of the clouds saying, that'll be $5, sir. Okay, he doesn't have any use for it. The things that are highly valued among men, often God finds detestable in the sight of God. That is what is written in your Bible. That is what it means to be a Christian. Those are the kind of beliefs you embrace and adopt and espouse, teach others. That's how you instruct properly, how you edify people, okay, is by those kind of teachings. It just comes from the Spirit of Truth, the Counselor. It's all there. We have equal access to the Spirit of Truth to tell us what to say, to help us think right, and to counsel us and adjust our thinking and expel the deceptions and the delusions that we have in our own minds about particular things. So I've named a few things that would change. And, this is a big deal. Huge, huge, huge changes. So if you're opposed to this guaranteed basic income, remember all the things you're opposed to. You're opposed primarily to the captives being set free, entirely free, completely free, utterly free, absolutely free, universally so. That means everybody, full freedom for everybody. You're opposed to Martin Luther King Jr. and what he believed was best to solve our problems. You're opposed, you're for the criminal industrial complex continuing unabated. You're for abortion by default, all these things you are. If you're against minimum guaranteed income for everybody and universal prosperity for everybody as a birthright, then you're opposed to that. You're opposed to ending abortion. You're opposed to ending prostitution. You're opposed to ending pedophilia. You're opposed to ending dubious war. You're opposed to ending all the homicides that are inspired from desperate poverty, provoked from desperate poverty, induced from desperate poverty. You're opposed to ending the welfare industrial complex. You're opposed to ending the financial services industrial complex. The national debt is included in that. It's all part and parcel. So you understand the implications of saying you're opposed to a basic guaranteed income and setting the captives free. You're opposed, literally, you're opposed to God's will being established on earth as it is in heaven. So anybody that wants to call me a communist or a socialist doesn't know their head from their butthole, okay? And I'm here to tell you, I'm no socialist. I'm no communist. I'm no fascist. But I am trying to be a decent, upright, fellow human being. That's it. And speak truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. And let the chips fall where they may. But it seems radical to some only because you've been trained to believe guys like me are radical. Oh, you're just a pipe-dreaming idealist. You're a freak, man. Nobody should listen to you, right? Because you're so entrenched. The evils of this world have been so imbued into your thinking, to your heart, and into your mind that you say, no, we've got to do things. We've got to tweak the system here and there and work within it and all this and that. And you know, that can't be the answer. We just need more jobs. We just need a better trade deal with China. And this is how Trump is going to fix America and all this. No, that's not it, okay? It's going to come when everybody gets it, okay? When we all, enough, a critical mass of people are empowered to demand change, to demand progress, to demand sound economic, monetary policies that are truly capitalistic, okay? That's it. And that leads to universal prosperity. Universal prosperity leads to universal freedom. Do you understand? So I know my stuff. I know exactly what I'm talking about here. There's no ifs, ands, or buts. There's no equivocation. The only reason things are evil in the land is because they've been made evil. They've been rendered evil over a long period of time by these evildoers at the top that are running the shows. Running the show, creating the policies that we all have to live under from birth. So get that straight. I'm on to recent events from the past week. Macron and Trump, let's see. Yeah, you know what? This bromance is kind of unbecoming, I think. It's really a spectacle, you know, Trump wiping schmutz off, you know, Macron's coat. But kind of funny. But maybe it is like Winston Churchill. You stay close. So Trump's a smart guy. He knows. Is Macron character? Okay, I firmly believe this clown has designs on being king of the world, emperor of the world, president of the earth. Okay, that's what I feel. I sense strongly from this guy. So watch this character. He could be a biblical character, but I don't trust that guy as far as I could throw him. No. Got a big fat smile, but what do they say about smiling faces? Smiling faces tell lies often. They don't tell the truth. Remember that song? Smiling faces tell lies. They don't tell the truth. Let's see what else. Last week I was talking about the politicization, I already touched on that, of law enforcement. Imagine it on a local basis. I mean, if you want to understand why it's so bad in these high-end law enforcement agencies like the FBI, well, just imagine if your local law enforcement was politicized, you know. So, no, we can't tolerate that. Kanye West is sure taking some heat for supporting Trump. He really triggered a lot of people when he wore his MAGA hat. That's so funny. We got the waffle shop, the naked AR-15 shooter, stopped by a very humble Good Samaritan